Jesus.
Yes. 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 Yes.
Wow, we thank God for what he's already done.
Already.
We thank God for what he's doing right now.
Right now.
Oh, you might look one way, but God is in charge.
He's in charge.
Yeah, yeah. She's gonna be all right. She's gonna be all right. Because God said, I won't leave you. Nor forsake you. My charge, see, I ain't even worried.
That's right.
My charge is sugar.
Sugar.
All right.
Psalms 19, verse 9 and 10.
That's all right.
Yeah. Read with me if you will. Don't take my word. I might be can't read. I might be added, and I might be subtracted. You read with me.
Yeah.
All right. The fear of the Lord is clean, enduring forever.
Yeah.
The judgment of the Lord are true and righteous altogether.
Yeah.
10 picks it up and say, more to be desired are they than gold, yet than fine gold.
Hallelujah.
Sweet also than honey,
uh-huh,
and the honeycomb, oh, sugar.
Yeah.
If I had to use for a subject,
yeah,
today, nothing brackish.
No, right now. Yeah.
That's a word my mama used to use all the time.
Yeah.
Make a little Kool-Aid, and she didn't have much sugar, and she said, this is brackish, David. That means there's not enough sugar in the Kool-Aid for it to be real Kool-Aid. Then she would make the jello and put the fruit in there, but sometimes she would get fruit that didn't have the sugar in it. Then she said, brackish jello. That means it's not sweet enough. But hearing the word of God, they're thinking that everything is going to
be all right.
That you're going to have fine gold and sweet gold and this, that, and the honeycomb. But the word of God said all of that is going to pass away.
Yes.
What you need is to get the real pure sugar in the vein all the way to the marrow of the bone. And that is to get the Holy Ghost on the inside of your life. That's what he's trying to tell you. You need to work till the day is done. And then you need to have on your whole armor of God. And you need to run this race with fear and trembling. You need to have that sugar. That sugar starts not at a 5-pound bag, not as a 10-pound bag, but that sugar starts at Genesis 1. You don't have the Spirit of God. See, the young lady started off and she sang a song.
Yeah, no.
And see, when God hears, the enemy hears his way.
Go ahead.
And she said, change me, oh God. Then she said, wash me through and through. And immediately, right there when God said, shut it. Immediately something started to happen. My subject today is eggs. And I'm going to, if I could have you, we're going to come from Deuteronomy 22 and 6. And it segues right into my sister's sermon. Amen?
Amen.
God is good.
Right on
top. Deuteronomy 22. If you come across a bird's nest beside the road, either in a tree or on the ground, and the mother is sitting on the young or on the eggs, do not take the mother with the young.
That's right.
Verse 7, you may take the young, but be sure to let the mother go, so that it may be good. So that it may go well with you, and you may have a long life. Father God, right now in the name of Jesus, we come to you as humble as we know how. God, we understand and we recognize that you are already in this holy place, God. You said that you'd never leave nor forsake us. And God, you're right here, right with thy people, Lord. There's some people in here that need some change in their life, God. There's some people in here that need some anointing in their life now. God, there's some people in here that need a healing in their body. Including my son who lays in a hospital bed right now, God. But I know that you're a healer. You've done it too many times. So God, God, I thank you right now begin to change in the atmosphere. And I said change in the atmosphere. Meaning that he's going to turn that supernatural thing into a natural that we might see him move. As I said, I just left my son in a hospital room again. In rehab and then having to be returned to ICU. But I have a charge over my life. And God said, you must do my bidding. My bidding. I'll take care of the rest. Right now, he's getting a drug called Zytoxin, which is normally for a chemotherapy patient. But Sarah, Dr. Chambers went through chemo last year. And I'm understanding, and I do understand that sometimes in order to live, you must die. Dying to self. So my son is just only going through his supernatural experience right now. So everything's all right, just like this mother can continue to preach after her daughter starts to have an attack. That's what a mother does. And as we look at the text today, it's talking about you don't take the mother when you take the young.
Preach it.
Understanding that the mother is the one that supersedes over the child. That teaches the child, that nourishes the child. Just as Mary took care of Jesus from the womb. Not understanding that I'm a virgin, but I carry something down on the inside that's going to change the world. My son's condition is going to change the world. Yes, he has a rare disorder that only over 21,000 people have. Rare. This young black man has something that the doctors here have never heard of. But God said that I'm going to change. Let them see that I'm still God. And I won't take the mother to get the child. So I can leave him in the nest. Drove in on Friday, took a shower and got straight to the hospital. But I knew there was a charge for today. That I must do what God has called me to do. Understanding that everything is going to be all right.
Amen.
And the title for today's message is, Only Take What You Need. Only take what you need.
Amen.
I grew up in the country, and one of my chores was to go out and gather the eggs.
Yeah.
And my daddy used to always say, don't bother the mother hen.
All right, yeah.
Now, as a child, I'm wondering, how do I get beneath her to get what I need? How do I know which ones to take? But instinctively, I knew the ones that I was supposed to gather.
Amen.
You see, I only took what I needed. Leaving the mother unharmed. She wasn't even upset by my taking from what she had. You see, Mary did the same thing. She took care of what God gave her. Huh?
Amen.
Knowing that one day I'm going to have to separate from this child.
Yes.
I'm going to have to get up off the nest. I'm going to see what the end's going to be. Because see, what God has put underneath you, what God has put in your belly, it must come to fruition. I've been pregnant 3 times and had 3 children. I understand that when that child is on the inside, something is going to happen. And you get your end result. Jesus in his mother's womb, being nurtured, being brought about that we might have life and life more abundantly.
Amen.
I understand that whenever something is happening to a child or to the young, the mother feels something.
Amen.
But you should not, you will not, when you're walking the walk with God and when God has called you and when God is in the end of your life, you cannot be moved by what you see. But you must be moved by the will of work and work of God. Understanding that the scripture that we read, it's talking about a hen, something we don't really think too much of. We think it's just a minute animal, but understand that hen is for your nutritional well-being.
Amen.
The word of God is for your spiritual well-being.
Yeah.
That you might be nourished.
Yeah.
That you might be fed. Yeah. That you wouldn't go around this world hungry for something that only God can give. That's peace. That's joy. That's understanding. Understanding that you and I, we with our natural minds, couldn't understand. We couldn't even take it if we were in our natural. But we understand that God is in charge of our life.
Yes, he
is. God gives us a call and a charge of our life that he be lifted up, that he be glorified, that he be worshipped, that he be adored. You see, I'm only taking what I need here. That is that I lift up the word of God, that I lift his name up, that I let you know who I'm talking about, why I'm talking about it, and how I'm talking about it. I'm talking about it with authority. Authority because I've seen too much. I've been around too long since God called me. Nothing's been the same. I cannot, I will not stop. You can't break me. As you go out through your days and your months and your years, doesn't matter what the world puts in front of you.
Amen.
Put God first.
All right.
And if you must take anything from the world, make sure that it's attached to God.
Amen.
And only take what you need.
What you need.
I tell you, I don't know about y'all, but our speakers have spoken from the depths of their hearts.
Yes.
We've had a glorious time. Is that all right?
All right.
Glory to God. But it's business time now.
Uh-huh.
It's business time. It's business time.
That
means some money time.
Uh-huh.
That means some money. Yeah. Give God a hand. Give him a hand. At this time, we will have our officers please come forward, and we're going to receive our offering in a very quiet way. And then we're going to give our announcements. And then we're going back into the remaining. of the service for the evening. Yes. Glory to God. Teach you guys when you come, an officer from the provincial house.
Let us pray. Father, in the name of Jesus, we give you thanks and praise. We thank you, Lord, for all that's transpired here so far this afternoon.
Yes, yes.
And we thank you, Lord, for the word we received as well as the offering we've just received.
Thank you.
Lord, your word says, give and it shall be given to you.
Amen.
Good measure, pressed down, shaken together, and running over, shall men give unto your bosom. For the measure with which you meet with all, it shall be measured back to you.
Amen.
Now, Lord, we believe that we receive according to your word.
Yes.
And in the name of Jesus, the anointed one and his anointing, and all who read said, praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Give yourselves a hand.